Friends, welcome to the series of production management. Today we are going to explore another topic that is known as the forecasting. As we all know that what is forecasting? Forecasting is very important because for all the production manager, it's the forecasting which tells them about the future demand in the market. So somewhere the demand depends upon the forecasting techniques. Forecasting techniques helps a production manager to know the demand of a product in the market, and according to that demand, he can sell his product, he can supply the product to the market. So somewhere the other, demand and supply can be balanced by the help of proper forecasting technique. So in this lecture, we are going to see that what is production and the forecasting issues. Now let's understand that what is forecasting. Forecasting is all about the forecast. Forecasts are a basic inputs in the decision process of operations management because they provide information of the future demand. Means that what is the demand in future? How much product is being required in the market in the future? So this is all be easily analyzed by the help of proper forecasting method. So forecast is all about getting the demand and managing that demand by the help of proper supply. So production management always works on this because he has to maintain a proper supply system in the market. Now what is the importance of forecasting? There are the two aspects which is very important for the forecasting which a production manager used to access. The first aspect is the expected value of demand, means how much demand of a product is being there in the market and what demand is going to be increased in the future. So the expected value is being counted over here. The second one is the degree of accuracy that can be assigned to the forecast. Means which method of forecasting production manager is taking in account, whether he is taking a method which is feasible, reliable, highly accurate, or he is taking some generalized method. So the accuracy of the data is highly reliable because it depends upon the demand of the product in the market. So these are the two aspects. The first aspect is this, that the expected value, and this expected value must be backed by certain accurate data. Now the areas in which forecasting is useful. What are the areas in which forecasting has been useful? The first one is new product or the process accounting. Whenever you are going to launch a new product, you have to estimate its cost. You have to see that the profit projection and cash management means you are launching an altogether new product. You are going to buy new machines. So cash management is very important. The profit margin is very important. So you have to calculate all those things. And while calculating all these things, you have to forecast the things. The second one is the finance. Finance is the backbone for any managerial activity. So here you have to take out the equipments, you have to buy the equipment, the timing at which you are going to buy the equipment and the amount required, the funding from where you are going to borrow it, you are going to take the loans, everything must be taken into consideration when we are taking this point into action. Then the third one is the human resource management. Right man, right place, right cost at right time is all about human resource management. So whenever you are going to do a forecast, you have to see that you are going to acquire the right person. You have to give proper induction and training, timely appraisal, the salary system, the grievances management. Every proper action must be taken over here. Then marketing. Marketing of a product is very important. The more the customer knows about the product, the more the demand of the product is being there. So marketing depends upon the pricing and promotion of the activity, as well as e-business strategies, global competition strategies, what are our competitors over there, how they are making their product, what is the unique quality which our product has from the other product. So all these things must be told to the customer, and this helps in the sales promotion. Now the next one is operations, the schedules which you have to make. The different capacity planning, the work assignment, workloads, inventory planning, make or buy decisions, outsourcing, project management, Everything should be done by the help of proper operations management. The logistic must be properly maintained. So, by the proper operations management, you can easily get the proper forecast. And the last one is product service design. Means you have sold the product to the customer and now you have to give the after sale services, revision of current features, design of new product or services. Sometimes the customer used to give a feedback that this is the specific feature which is not being working properly, or this product can be upgraded by these features. So these required a continuous change in the product. So all these changes must be properly accumulated in time so that our product beats the market demand and it is always being the better amongst all the competitors which are there in the market. Now the next is objectives of the demand forecasting. There are the six objectives of a demand forecasting. The first one is timely. You must know, as a product manager, you must have a proper knowledge of a timing. At what time the demand of the product is there in the market, and according to that you have to plan all the activity. So time is very important. As a production manager, in advance you have to do all the activity. Second one is reliable. The data which you are going to take must have the reliability criteria. Means the data which you are collecting is from the reliable sources and has certain accuracy. Therefore, the third point is it has an accurate value. Means the data, the source of data is reliable, as well as whatever data we have collected has got the accuracy in the system. Then easy to use. Means whatever data we have taken, the person who is using the data must have a proper knowledge of interpreting the data. He must have a knowledge to analyze the data. So the data must be presented in a very easy form. Then meaningful, means whatever data you are taking must have a proper use in our study. A production manager knows that whatever data he is taking has a proper relationship with the product he is dealing with. So there must be a proper relationship between the product and the demand in the market. Then the last one is written. Means whatever data you are taking, whatever the data analysis you are going to do, it should be done in a written form. Why? Because the medium of communication should be in written, as it is a demand and supply activity. A manager used to think that this percentage, our demand may increase by 30%, but he is thinking, he hasn't have told to his juniors or the supervisors. So supervisor doesn't know. So all the activity of the data must be in written. So a written data analysis also helps the other members of the team to get the idea that what is going to be happening in the future. So these are the six objectives of the demand forecasting, that it must be have a timely data, then it must be reliable, it must be accurate, it must be meaningful, written and easy to use. Now, what are the approaches of forecasting? If you are going to do a forecasting system, how you are going to approach towards the forecasting? How you are going to collect the data? And whether that data is being useful for the production manager or not. So the first one is, you can divide the data on the basis of a qualitative analysis, and the second one is on the basis of quantitative analysis. When we talk about qualitative analysis, we feel that, we assume that the data which we are taking is for the long term, and the data which we are going to analyze is for the long term. That means a company is planning for 5 years, 10 years, 3 years. So here qualitative data is being taken into consideration, because company is dealing with each and every aspect of a product. And when the company is going to deal with a short time framework, they are going to take with the quantitative data. In quantitative data, we take the data which is being used in quantitative terms. How much product is being sold off? what is the market price, at what price the competitor is selling the product. So all these things are taken into consideration. So there are two approaches of forecasting. Whenever a production manager or a production house used to do a long-term planning, they go with the qualitative data approach, and when they are going to do with the short-term timing, they are going to go with the quantitative framework. Now, steps in forecasting. As you see, there are six steps of forecasting. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And all these steps of forecasting is very important and very crucial for a production manager. Why? Because each and every step helps the next step to get the reliable and accurate data. The first one is determine the purpose of the forecasting. Why you are going to do the forecasting? Why? Whether you are going to do the forecasting for the demand of the product in the market, whether you are going to do the forecasting on the price of the product, whether you are going to do the forecasting on the features of the product, or you are going to sell a new product and the research and development is being required, any innovation which is going to be done by the company. So here, the first thing is that you have to determine the purpose of the forecasting. Now the second step is establish the time horizon. Time horizon means here you have to see, you have to deal that what is the time horizon on which you are going to work, whether it is a quarterly, half yearly or yearly. If you are going to make a new product and you are going to launch a new product, automatically your time horizon is very less. From 15 to 20 days, you have to give a new innovative product. Because innovation requires time. You have to do a lot of research and development. So after doing all this activity, you are going to get the second step, that is you are going to establish the time horizon on which you are going to do the forecast. Whether it is for long term or whether it is for short term. For long term, you are going to deal with the qualitative data. For short term, you are going to deal with the quantitative data. Then select a forecasting technique. There are different techniques of forecasting. When we talk about qualitative techniques, there are Delphi techniques. When we talk about quantitative techniques, you have got time series techniques. Apart from this, there are many numerous techniques of demand forecasting. You all have heard. But these two techniques we are going to deal with. So we are talking the name over here. Then data collection and analysis. If you have taken the qualitative technique, you have to collect questionnaire data on the basis of questionnaire schedules, and that contains the data that is being known as the qualitative data. Yes, no series, Likert scale, behavior scale, everything can be used over there. So if it is a qualitative data, it may be ranked also. And if it is a quantitative data, it is a numeric data. Then you have got the fifth point, prepare the forecast. Now you have got the data, you have used the statistical techniques. There are different statistical tools. Regression analysis you have applied. Why regression analysis? Because regression analysis is an analysis on which you are using the past data to predict the future. Correlation you have applied, t-test you have applied, f-test you have applied, z-test you have applied. There are numerous statistical tools you have applied on the basis of the requirement of the forecast. And after that, you have prepared the forecast that on the basis of this statistical tool, this is the result we are getting. And at the last, monitor the forecast means we have applied that in our forecasting techniques, and now we will sit and monitor that feedback, proper feedback system is working, and our forecasting is accurate or not, it is reliable or not, whatever we have forecasted is matching with the real value or not. So these are the steps in the forecasting. Types of forecast. So there are three main types of forecasting. The first one is judgmental forecasting. The judgmental forecasting means that when you have got certain intuitions, certain purposes, you are going to take decisions, you are going to take the judgment according to that. Whatever knowledge you have got, whatever exposure you have got, on the basis of that exposure, whatever alternatives you have, according to that alternatives, you are selecting the best alternatives, and on the basis of that, you are judging that this is the best you can do for an organization, for your product. So as a product manager, a person can do the forecasting on the basis of judgmental. Then the second one is time series. Time series means that you have certain time horizons, and according to that, you give the inputs. You have got data, yearly data, quarterly data. You have got data of 10 years, 15 years, 16 years, and you make a time series over here. And on the basis of time series, you are going to predict the value. And the last one is the associative model. Associative model means there are certain models which is being impactly or directly designed for that specific system, and that helps the production manager to get the accurate data. If you are working in space science, so you have got, there are different associative models which predict over there the environment, at what velocity the satellite is going to be launched, at what time it is going to reach. So everything depends upon the associative model. It doesn't comes with the judgmental and time series. So associative model works over there where we have got certain extraordinary things. Now, as I have told you that the forecasting techniques is very important for any of the business manager. A production manager always used to see that a proper forecasting system must be applied in his organization. Because the demand and supply, the balance between two is almost dependent upon the forecasting. The best method you apply for the forecasting, the best method you can take, or the more profit you can gain in the business. I hope you have understood this. Thank you.